the back of the dress, I've folded the fabric in half. I've laid the two front pieces on top of the back, bearing in mind that on the front here, I'm going to be seaming this. So I've taken that into consideration and I've left this fabric for the upper dress slightly overhanging to the point where it's going to be the finished line, because there's going to be no seam in on the center back, where there is going to be a seam on the center front. Apart from this, we're just going to mark off the neckline at the back. The neckline is just the basic neckline, angling it off at the shoulder. Now the armhole has been cut in quite deep, and we're going to allow the ease for the back. Also on the bust area, I want it wider at the front than I do at the back, so I'm going to meet these points, taking that into consideration. And then from the hip downwards, it's exactly the same as what the front piece is. So just mark all this across, cut into it, and our front and the back of the dress completed. Now the sleeves, I'm going to fold this in half. Measure the length of the sleeves. The length of the sleeves that I want is 24 inches. On the bottom, I'm going to be adding fabric that's going to be the same as the bottom of my dress. Now here on the arm circumference, I'm just going to measure this around. I don't want the sleeves overly wide at this point. And my bicep measurements are loosely fitting approximately 12 inches. So believe it or not, that's the fitting line I would be looking at. So because I don't want the sleeves overly wide, I'm going to just slightly angle it out, and then measuring down. Otherwise, the armhole will not fit in. I'm going to mark this 6 inches down and going on the curve. Cut into this. It's a quite a deep cut sleeve, but the deeper the length of the sleeve here, the better fitting you would get, the better hanging, especially on stiffer fabrics. Now, like I said earlier, the excess fabric, just keep that to a side, because I'm going to show you some of the other outfits that I'm going to do where on plain fabric, plain linen, and I will add this fabric. It's got a beautiful foil print which is on a polka dot, very small polka dot, and it will look very effective, and I will show you a couple of designs that I will be doing in that. So rather than going and spending money on extra fabrics or extra accessories, we're going to use that to make a completely new, different, unique type of an outfit. Perhaps with that neckline that I was showing you earlier on, we might go for one of those. Now this is the front of the sleeve, and I'm going to cut into this. With a bit of imagination and hard work, it's wonders what you can achieve with spare fabrics. And that's where the uniqueness and the effect of designing comes into force. So the difference between the front and the back is quite apparent, as you can see. I've already marked this off as my center. Now I'm just going to go around and find some interfacing that I want to put the neckline on. Now, this has already been a pre-cut interfacing, but I think it'd be sufficient for what I require it. Now, just on the now, what I would want you to do is just pin that into place. And what we're going to do is measure the length of our neckline. I'm going to mark this off at approximately 9 inches. This is the finished neckline, and then 8 inches to where I would want the scout of the neckline. 3.5 inches and 4.5 inches. So this point I'm going to meet here, and that point I'm going to meet on the outer one. Now I'm going to cut into this and then slightly angle in, and then cut the V, slightly shape it at the top, and I'll just show you the reason why I left that overhanging is because the finished result will look like this, and I've left that purposely because if I'd made the complete V, it would be overlapping at these points. So that's the pieces for my neckline. That's the sleeve, and these are all my excess pieces. This is the fabric for the salwar. The salwar I'm going to cut as very, very basic salwar, because it's just a normal salwar, but it's going to have some added pieces at the bottom. So the basic salwar, this is in cotton, so I don't want to make it heavy or anything, because the hanging will not be the same. So this I would call a kali salwar. I think I'm going to teach you a slight variation on this one. Now the variation that I'm going to teach you is take this piece . This is a turning for our this is going to be the ponja, and we're going to put kaliya in this. It's not going to, like I said, it's not going to be overly heavy salwar. So the width of this salwar, we're just going to make it